Hey guys, today we are going to talk about Ken Goldin and the rise of Goldin Auctions. Stick around. Hello to all my sports card collector, investor, all the collectibles friends out there in the universe. I hope that you're doing fantastically well today. It is Wednesday. Tonight I'm going to be on Because I'm Carlos YouTube channel, and we're going to talk about collectibles as a whole and specifically graded video games. I'm excited to be on his channel tonight, so definitely tune in for that. Before I get started, please, if you like what you hear, hit that subscribe button, the like button, the notification bell, all the buttons. If you could hit those down there, I would really appreciate it. It helps with the YouTube algorithm. I know everybody says the same thing, but it really is true, and it helps this channel grow. We are just about to 12,000 subscribers. I'm excited about it. It's a milestone for us, and so please help us get there. It'd be great. I do come out with 4, 5, 6 videos a week on this channel, all about collectibles, sports cards, etc., and we'll keep it going. All right, today I want to highlight a growing company in the sports card hobby market, and I've talked about this in previous videos. I think that this cottage hobby, I know, is not really a cottage hobby anymore, and a lot of the older players or ones that have been around are really expanding, broadening their wings, and things are happening. Ken Goldin of Goldin Auctions would be one of these companies that's really, really making moves here recently. Ken Goldin has been in the sports card, sports memorabilia game for 30 plus years. I saw in an interview, his first pack of cards was 72 tops. So he has been around and doing this for a long time. And in 2012, he started Goldin Auctions and has really built that company up. They've now sold more than $1 billion worth of sports cards and sports memorabilia in a short period of time, really. And it's just been a massive snowball effect. Ken Goldin, I don't know him personally, but when I do see interviews, and he's been on big stations, he's been on Fox News, he's been on Bloomberg TV, he's been on ESPN. He is no stranger to professional athletes as far as getting autograph deals and all of these things. He's a longtime guy in the hobby, but his company has really, really expanded. He made a pretty big move recently when he sold to Nat Turner and their investment group as they are building out their portfolio in this space. And essentially kind of the thought behind that from what he said was, is he would like to be a part of something larger to really expand his business. He's still going to run his business the same way that he always has. But, you know, the website, even just recently, his website crashed because of all the demand and just being able to build out that infrastructure. They've got a deal with Barstool Sports that they've got in place, and they've got other media content that they have in the works, not to mention a reality show. And I saw that it is going to be called, I believe it's going to be called The Goldin Touch. And my expectation for this, and I don't know what station it's going to be on, if it's going to be on Bravo or History Channel or one of these big networks, but I kind of get the feeling like this is going to be a big deal where it's on, you know, a major network, and it's kind of a Pawn Stars, you know, type show, American Pickers, if you will, or some sort of reality show that revolves around sports cards and, you know, big sports cards, auctions, etc. I think it's going to be really exciting to watch and something that really gets into the mainstream, the fabric of society, the culture, if you will. I mean, we've talked about it. There's a lot of influencers in this space that have, you know, huge followings, like the Gary V's and the Steve Aoki's of the world. And Ken Goldin is looking to kind of broaden that out as well with this reality show and grow the hobby to be more mainstream. It was more mainstream. If we go back to 1990, you know, it's like every kid in school, you know, had baseball cards, had basketball cards, football cards, and we're collecting. But this is a whole nother animal that's growing out. And it's not just, you know, focused on those, you know, on the young people. It's also expanding out even more so as a alternative investment, alternative asset that adults are looking at buying into. It's become big business here over the last 3-4 years, and it looks to be expanding, or they're looking to expand it out that way. So it's very exciting. And then Goldin also had made a deal, I believe it was in Japan or it was in Asia specifically, to be able to kind of expand out so that Asian audience can basically, you know, bid and buy Goldin Auctions. So that's another thing, looking to go more international. They're in big growth mode. It's amazing to watch. The deal with Barstool Sports can't be understated. I mean, Barstool is massive and growing, and it's just one of kind of, I've noticed they've really trying to broaden out their content. Goldin Auctions content on YouTube, I've seen it, and I believe through podcasts and other places. So they're really kind of hitting it all the way around. They also have a new vault service, which I think was interesting too, that I don't know if it was recently announced, but their first week, they just started out, in their first week, they had more than $50 million that was added to their vault in just the first week. $50 million of collectibles. They have it advertised that it's free for life to vault if you vault in 2021. They do allow drop-offs and pickups. And my feeling about the free vaulting service, I have to assume that is so that they are able to auction it off eventually. So people vault their stuff, and when they go to sell, Goldin says, oh, well, sell through us. You've got it through our vault, in kind of the same way that PWCC and Alt are doing. So Goldin is in on this vault business. And so PWCC now has, you know, serious, serious competition in this space. And so, again, I think that, you know, competition is always a good thing when it comes to this stuff. So it's, again, you have Goldin just kind of getting in on all sorts of different things. It'll be interesting to see how they further look to expand their business moving forward. And it's exciting. And I wanted to highlight this business as kind of one that is making moves in the hobby. It's one among many. And with all the new startups and all the competition that's coming, you know, it'll be very interesting to see kind of which big players get into this space to compete with all these other companies. So guys, thank you very, very much for joining me here today. Let me know your thoughts on this and kind of your thoughts on just the hobby in general. Where do you like where things are going? Do you miss kind of the old hobby, the way that it was? Do you think that we'll ever get back to that? Or do you think big business or medium-sized business, you know, will come in and kind of move this, kind of evolve this hobby into something different, or even more so than it already has? Let me know your thoughts in the comments. Thank you very much for joining me for another video. Stay healthy, stay awesome, and I will see you again next time.